Hypothesis testing. Hypothesis testing is a key procedure in inferential statistics. It is based on the idea that we can tell things about a population from a sample taken from it. Hypothesis testing can be explained in 5 steps: hypotheses, significance, sample, p-value, decide. Step 1, hypotheses. Decide on your hypotheses. You need a null hypothesis, H0, and an alternative hypothesis, H1 or HA. Inferential statistics is based on the premise that you cannot prove something to be true, but you can disprove something by finding an exception. You decide what you're trying to provide evidence for, which is the alternative hypothesis, then you set up the opposite as the null hypothesis and find evidence to disprove that. It can be said that the alternative hypothesis is usually a thing we are trying to prove or find out about, while the null hypothesis is the opposite or status quo. Note 1. The hypotheses are always about the population parameters, not the sample values or statistics. 2. The null hypothesis usually refers to the status quo, the thing we are trying to find evidence against. It generally represents no effect. And 3, the null hypothesis should include a statement of equality and the alternative should not. Step 2, significance. Decide on a level of significance. Unless there is a good reason not to, people generally use 0.05 as a significance level, also known as the alpha value. The significance level is the probability that you will say that the null hypothesis is wrong when really it is correct. This is known as a type 1 error. Step 3. Take a sample from the population to provide the statistics you need. Step 4. Calculate the p-value. This is almost always done by a computer package. Step 5. Use the p-value to decide whether to reject the null hypothesis. If the p-value is less than the significance level you chose earlier, you will reject the null hypothesis. The sample has given you evidence that the null hypothesis is wrong. We will now go through this step by step with an example. Helen sells Choconutties. Her brother Luke is taking a marketing class and tells her that people will buy more Choconutties from her if she gives away a free gift with each packet. Helen is skeptical, so decides to gather data to see if it's true. She decides that for the next month she will try out some days where she offers a free sticker with each packet of Choconutties and some when she doesn't. From the month of trials, she will have a sample that can be used to draw conclusions about days in the future. The population in this instance is all days of selling Choconutties. The sample is the days that occur in the next month. This is not a random sample, but it is all we can do in this instance. To make the assignment of sticker or no sticker random, Helen will toss a coin each morning, and if it is heads, she will offer a free sticker. She will keep track of her sales for each day. She asks you to help her do the analysis. The first step is to decide on the hypotheses. There are 2 different circumstances, sometimes known as treatments, offering a sticker and not offering. The null hypothesis is that there is no difference in the sales for the 2 treatments. The statistic of interest is the mean or average value of daily sales. The null hypothesis can be written H0, there is no difference in mean sales for the population for the 2 treatments. The alternative hypothesis is written H1, there is a difference in mean sales for the population for the 2 treatments. Helen thinks the sales could go up or down as a result of offering a free sticker. Written in mathematical terminology, we use mu, a Greek letter, to represent the population mean. These are the mean sales for all days that Choconutties are sold. These are different from the sample means, which are the values we calculate from our data. The subscript free sticker or no sticker indicates whether we're talking about the population mean for days when a free sticker is offered or when it is not. Written mathematically, it looks like this. H0 mu free sticker equals mu no sticker, which rearranges to H0 mu free sticker minus mu no sticker equals 0. Note that there is an equals sign in the null hypothesis. Similarly, the alternative hypothesis looks like this. We do not know what the values of the population means are, but we will use information from the sample to get sample means, which will then help us make inferences about the population means and the difference between them. There is a not equal to sign in the alternative hypothesis. This means we are interested in differences from zero in both directions. This is called a two-tailed test or exploratory hypothesis. If Helen was sure that the sales would not go down and was only interested in whether they went up or stayed the same, the hypotheses would look like this. H1, the mean sales for the population for the free sticker treatment, are higher than the mean sales for the population for the no sticker treatment. H0, the mean sales for the population for the free sticker are less than or the same as the mean sales for the population for no sticker. Written in mathematical terminology, the hypotheses look like this. This can be rearranged to this if Helen is looking for evidence that sales will increase due to the free sticker. This is called a one-tailed test or a directional hypothesis. It has a greater than sign in it. We will stick to the two-tailed test for now. Step 2. Decide on a level of significance. We choose alpha equals 0.05. Step 3. Helen goes ahead with her plan and provides 23 days of sales figures, 13 of which were when she offered the free stickers and 10 when she did not. You put the figures in a spreadsheet and use Excel to draw histograms of the data and calculate the appropriate p-value. The process for calculating the p-value is shown in a separate video called Two Means T-Test in Excel. The results look like this. The mean sales for the free sticker days is $301.92, while the mean sales for the no free sticker days is $265.83. Step 4. You see that the p-value for the two-tailed test is given as 0.01998, which rounds to 0.02. Step 5. The calculated p-value of 0.02 is less than the level of significance, which is 0.05, so you reject the null hypothesis. Helen would like to know what that means, so you explain that the data she has collected indicates that there is a difference in mean sales depending on whether she offered a free sticker or not. If she had chosen a one-tailed test, then the p-value for that would be 0.00999, or rounded to 0.01. Important points to remember. The hypotheses are made about the population. We collect sample data to draw inference about the population. We know whether there is a difference between the sample means. We use information about the samples to decide, using the p-value, whether there is evidence to say that there is a difference between the population means. You might like to watch Understanding the P-Value to help your understanding, or Two Means T-Test in Excel to learn how to go about doing this test using the Excel Analysis Toolpack.